Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy-to-understand whiteboard videos. And today, let's deep dive into protocol buffers. By definition, protocol buffers are a method of serializing data that can be transmitted over wire or be stored in files. The other formats like JSON or XML are also used for serializing data, but they aren't fully optimized for scenarios where the data is to be transmitted between multiple microservices in a platform-neutral way. That's why developers prefer protocol buffers over them. The Protobuf or protocol buffer is optimized to be faster than JSON and XML by removing many responsibilities usually done by data formats and making it focus only on the ability to serialize and deserialize data as fast as possible. The definition of data to be serialized is written in configuration files called proto files with the extension .proto. These files will contain the configuration known as messages. Let's look in detail at key features of protobufs. Number 1. The protobuf is binary transfer format, meaning that the data is transmitted as binary. This improves the speed of transmission more than raw string because it takes less space and bandwidth. Number 2. Separation of context and data. In JSON and XML, the data and context are not separable, whereas in protobuf, it is separable. Number 3. Message format. As we have discussed before as well, the data is transmitted as protobuf based on a configuration file known as messages. Further, let's discuss about reasons to use protocol buffers. Reason number 1. Schemas are awesome. That means encoding the semantics of a business object in proto format is enough to help ensure that signal does not get lost between applications and boundaries you create enforce your business rules. Reason number 2. Backward compatibility for free. Proto files can prevent errors and make rolling out new features and services way simpler than JSON and XML. Number 3. Validation and extensibility. The required, optional, and repeated keywords in protocol buffer's definition are extremely powerful. They allow you to encode at the schema level. Reason number 4. Easy language interoperability. Because protocol buffers are implemented in a variety of languages, they make interoperability between polyglot applications in your architecture much simpler. You simply have to hand the proto file to code generator written in target language, and you have some nice guarantees about safety and interoperability between those architectures. Last but not the least, when is JSON a better fit? There do remain times when JSON is better fit than something like protocol buffers, including situations where you need or want data to be human readable. Number 2. When data from service is directly consumed by web browser. Number 3. When your server-side application is written in JavaScript. Number 4. When you aren't prepared to tie the data model to a schema. Number 5. When you don't have the bandwidth to add another tool to your arsenal. Number 6. Then the operational burden of running a different kind of network service is too great. With that, I hope this video was helpful and served value to you. Be sure to smash that like button and subscribe for future updates.